Sheep first came to the American colonies from Britain in 1601, and from then on, sheep, and especially wool production, was a crucial force in the development of the early colonial economy. During the 17th and 18th centuries, the exchange of wool and woolen goods not only cemented a thriving industry in the colonies, but it also contributed to the competitive tension between the colonies and Britain. The British Parliament carefully regulated trade in the colonies, and in 1699, they passed the Wool Act, one of the Navigation Acts, which restricted the export of wool and sheep from the colonies, and ensured that any woolen products produced by the colonists had to be sold to British markets. This control outraged many colonists, for they encountered a situation that greatly limited and controlled their growing market, in which they held great pride. In effect, these colonists together explored alternative markets and rebellion, which eventually led to the American Revolution. The sheep is an animal like none other. It was one of the very first animals ever to be domesticated by humans, and supplies us with many valuable resources. Meat and milk for consumption, wool for warmth, clothing, shelter, and even simple labor. Sheep are also extremely adaptable. They can survive in cool, rocky climates like the Highlands of Scotland, but also thrive in the dry American West and all over Australia and New Zealand. Wool, arguably the sheep's most unique trait, has been spun and worn for centuries, since the beginning of sheep husbandry until the modern day. Wool absorbs water, does not smell, and accepts colored dye fantastically.
I think one of the things that's great about wool and makes it very appealing is how well it takes color, so that you get really vibrant colors out of it, and they are maintained in wool more easily. They don't fade the way they do on cotton. And so you can get really rich, luscious looking fabrics using wool.
Long before the British colonized America, they had been practicing sheep farming and had built their woolen industry to be one of their most profitable markets, in which they took great pride. In 1601, the first sheep were brought from England to Jamestown, Virginia. This was during the Elizabethan era, the time of William Shakespeare, the bubonic plague, and major social and economic growth in England. The first sheep that were brought over were cheap and of poor quality, with coarse wool. All of the high-quality breeds, like the coveted merinos, were kept in England. However, lack of quality did not deter the colonists. They were eager to boost the economy and sheep farming in the New World. Individually, colonies such as Massachusetts passed laws that required households to produce a set amount of wool each month. Other organizations, in promotion of economic growth, offered medals and assembled contests to encourage growth of the market. Soon, the American colonies gained a wool and sheep market of their own. From this economy, they developed a large network of exchange, even though they didn't have the quality of wool that England had. They exchanged wool and sheep with many cultures, including the Dutch, Irish, Spanish, and of course, the British people. This exchange earned them wealth, and from there, they could import higher quality breeds of sheep, expanding their market farther. Unfortunately for the colonists, who by the late 17th century had already opened a large number of woolen mills, the British weren't pleased with the thriving wool market overseas. In fact, they were jealous and felt threatened by the colonies. The British economy at the time relied so greatly on wool that being surpassed by their own colonists would probably be devastating for their economy, not to mention their pride. Alternatively, the colonists saw their network of exchange as completely fair. They had worked to establish their own economy and enjoy the freedom of their own economic relationships and separate markets.
the wool industry was extremely important in Great Britain. And in fact, they kept cotton out at first of Great Britain. They put taxes on cotton so that they were more expensive. The wool industry was really influential in the British economy, and therefore, in colonial times, it was very significant in the American economy as well, because they controlled the trade and they could tell the colonies whom they could trade with and who was off limits.
In retaliation to the growing market, England passed the Wool Act in 1699. The Wool Act, one of the many navigation acts, restricted any exchange of wool or sheep in the colonies. All wool that would normally be exported to other places had to be sold to England first. All wool was heavily taxed. The Wool Act was a turning point in history and set the colonists on a road to revolution. In the short term, the Wool Act outraged the colonists. They encountered a situation in which their wool economy halted. England was in complete control of their economy. Colonists reacted differently, but nearly all reactions were negative. The impact of this encounter spawned tension between the colonists and the British people. One of the ways that the colonists retaliated against the Wool Act was by exploring new markets. The colonists explored other fibers, such as flax, hemp, linen, and cotton, that could be used as alternatives to wool, and as means to regain a controllable economy. Other colonists wore homespun wool as a symbol of independence, a new idea for them in itself. Others still explored rebellion and illegally smuggled and sold sheep and wool. This rebellion, defiance, and protest led to many instances of violence, such as the Boston Massacre, where 5 colonists were shot and killed because they were rebelling against the British troops. Instead of controlling the angry colonists, instances such as the Boston Massacre only made them more upset. In the long term, the Wool Act factored in as a cause of the American Revolution. It was an accumulation of acts such as the Wool Act, along with heavy taxes and other factors, that eventually sent England and the colonists into war. This war was one of the most important in American history since, after all, it did allow for America to be a country. Even after the war, both America and Britain supported thriving wool economies and still do today. Sheep and their wool have been a part of human history since the earliest of husbandry. And it is important to American and British history, as well as many other cultures.